Why is Zoidberg the only one still alone?
'Cause he's a loser, that's why. He's the lobster equivalent of Fry.
Hey, I can get any girl I want anytime I want. I'm just too busy. Are there any left?
There may be one. Okay, it's $500. You have no choice of carrier. The battery can't hold a charge, and the reception isn't very...
Shut up and take my money!
Damn! One rock short of rescue!
This is Hermes. A package just came in. Everyone needs to return to the office immediately. Get away, you filthy bird! Shoo! Professor, turn me off, quick!
I'm sorry, what?
See you at the office!
Hey, don't cut that. I need that to speak.
Hey, Santa, when you see the robot devil, tell him I'm a-coming.
Hey, that guy said to tell you that...
I heard him.
Hey, what are these rings in Nibbler's fang?
I'm still a little woozy from a gazelle kick this morning, but if he's anything like the common tree, the rings might indicate his age.
Yeah, well, good luck. It'd take some kind of genius to count all those rings.
He's 5.
I can't keep running people over. I'm not famous enough to get away with it. Can't you help me?
Come on, Bender. You can do it.
Can't. I can't do it.
Yes!
You were right, Fry. I'm unstoppable.
No, we're not. And as vice chairman, I believe I speak for the entire board when I issue this challenge to Mom. Look at my butt! Woo!
You call that a press cam?
Look out! We're heading straight for those trees!
Yeah, yeah, relax. Trees down!
Trees down!
Cool. Hey, what do you do if you want the trees up?
Trees up!
Trees down!
Trees down!
You gotta help me. Send an army or something. Something big that shoots.
Sir, I don't care if you are my biggest contributor. Our armed forces do not serve your private business interests.
Oh, sorry, I...
I'm just yanking your chain, Leo. I'm on it like boring on Jerry Ford.
You see, nowadays, we can take a unique and beautiful object and easily reduce it to a formula for mass production. I call the process science.
Okay, I gotta break down that gate, beat up those 3 guards, steal that chopper, and rescue Bender. Hey, I did it! Wait, that's not me.
Come on, we gotta save Bender.
You wanna save him too, Lemon? You barely know him.
Fry, don't you recognize me?
Hermes?
Did you really think you'd need all this junk in the afterlife?
Afterlife? If I thought I had to go through a whole nother life, I'd kill myself right now.
Please, everyone knows 20th century colleges were basically expensive daycare centers.
That's true. By current academic standards, you're merely a high school dropout.
What?
Hey, Fry, think fast! Get it? It's chlorine!
It's funny because it's poisonous.
I almost feel like we should do something to help her.
We should do something.
I don't care what you say, Hermes. Let's go.
I'm sorry you saw that, Fry. I usually try to keep my sadness pent up inside, where it can fester quietly as a mental illness.
Yeah, I do that with my stupidness.
I see some movement up there. I think it's him.
Stand back.
Oops.
Don't worry. They'll be fine once the tranquilizer wears off.
Here it comes.
A mysterious world in the darkest depths of the Forbidden Zone.
Thank you and good night.
Professor, are we even allowed in the Forbidden Zone?
Why, of course. It's just a name, like the Death Zone or the Zone of No Return. All the zones have names like that in the Galaxy of Terror.
Professor...
Off you go. Pleasant trip.
Oof. If that stuff wasn't real, how can I be sure anything is real? Is it not possible, nay, probable, that my whole life is just a product of my or someone else's imagination?
No, get out.
As Wong's security chief, you will be on hand when he attempts to destroy the Violet Dwarf. You must not let that happen.
Must let happen.
Not happen.
Must let occur.
Head up, up, up. Ah, my head! My precious head!
Oh!
Stupid can opener. You killed my father, and now you've come back for me.
You all right, Bender?
Yeah, I guess so. But I don't see why we keep this ticking time bomb around just for that dumb animal.
Don't yell at Nibbler like that. You haven't been to work in 3 days. What have you been doing?
I've been sitting right here. I picked up my life exactly where I left off 1,000 years ago. Now, if you'll excuse me, it's 8 o'clock. Time to get busy.
I like big butts and I cannot lie. You other brothers can't deny.
You can't just sit here in the dark listening to classical music.
I could if you hadn't turned on the lights and shut off the stereo.
Fry, this isn't healthy.
What's in the box, Schrodinger?
A cat, some poison, and a cesium atom.
The cat, is it alive or dead? Alive or dead?
Answer him, fool.
It's a superposition of both states until you open it and collapse the wave function.
Says you.
There's also a lot of drugs in there.
Everyone, get in bed with me. I have something to show you. Feast your eyes on this.
It's beautiful.
And huge.
Can I touch it?
So what is it already?
It's a single atom of jumbonium.
But I can't play anymore.
Yes, you can. The beauty was in your heart, not your hands. Your music's bad and you should feel bad.
What time is it?
Time for you to shut up!
That form isn't about you. It refers to my high school prom date. It was a regulation date that ended in regulation disappointment.
Yes, but you only stamped it 4 times!
No! I was young and reckless.
Bureaucrat Conrad, you are technically correct. The best kind of correct.
Now open your mouth and let's have a look at that brain. No, 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 not that mouth.
I only have one.
Really?
Is there a human doctor around?
Young lady, I'm an expert on humans. Now pick a mouth, open it and say... What? My mother was a saint. Get out.
Heck. I hereby promote you to Executive Delivery Boy.
Executive?
It's a meaningless title, but it helps insecure people feel better about themselves.
I feel better about myself!
Professor, you'll offer Gunter the hat, and Fry, you'll offer him the banana. We'll let him choose whether he wants to be intelligent or just a mindless animal.
Come on, Gunter. Take the hat. No, the banana. The banana. Consider the philosophical and metaphysical ramifications of
banana,
the...
Banana, banana, banana!
$50 for the kid.
Hey, my clothes are worth $50.
Deal.
How can I let this happen? I can't go through the rest of my life like this.
Don't you have a self-destruct button?
Yeah, but it's on my body. What am I gonna do? I don't have an addictive personality.
Of course, even if it is possible to analyze the message, there's no way of knowing how long it would take. It could take an hour, or it could take 100 million years. Is it done? Certainly not. 2 dings means it's done. But not like that. Slightly more rapid.
It's crazy. How could they even know about a show from 1,000 years ago?
Well, Omicron Persei 8 is about 1,000 light years away. So the electromagnetic waves would just recently have gotten there. You see...
Magic. Got it. What do you heads do all day?
We share our wisdom with those who seek it. It's a life of quiet dignity.
Feeding time.
The feast of a thousand beasts is begun.
You can eat that?
Maybe later.
Relax. She can't be my grandmother. I figured it all out.
Of course she's your grandmother, you perverted dope. Look!
Come back to bed, dearie.
Ah! It's impossible. I mean, if she's my grandmother, who's my grandfather?
Isn't it obvious? You are.
Just the people this mind switcher was made for by us. Wait, can I still change my mind?
Let's find out.
It didn't work, you doddering old...
Oh, man, I'm inhaling these things. You guys scored some primo stuff here.
They're tastier than an unguarded penguin nest. What do you call them?
We haven't thought of a name yet.
Well, they're tasty, right? Let's call them tasticles.
Thank you, Professor Farnsworth, for your generous gift, which has once and for all disproven evolution. Behold, Homo Farnsworth frolicking with dinosaurs at the moment of creation.
I don't want to live on this planet anymore. This is quite a large ranch you have.
17.9 billion acres. We own the entire Western Hemisphere. That's the best hemisphere.
It's the same on Earth.
Okay. Neck. Tap. Tap. Climb. Climb. And we're back in business.
Should we be watching this? It seems kind of personal.
That's not an issue for us. We're wildlife.
What about the moaning? Is it okay to listen?
Sure, but act like it's no big deal. Just pretend you're eating seeds.
Is it weird if I talk about his crazy turtle penis?
No. Yeah, but it'll never bring back my martini. Well, who wants a martini?
Good work, everyone. The mother's ship is destroyed. What the hell is that thing?
It appears to be the mothership.
Then what did we just blow up?
The Hubble telescope.
It is completely reckless. Don't you ever think ahead?
Hell no. If I stopped to think ahead, I wouldn't be emperor, and I wouldn't even be here in the year 3000. It's just like the story of the grasshopper and the octopus. All year long, the grasshopper kept burying acorns for winter, while the octopus mooched off his girlfriend and watched TV. But then the winter came, and the grasshopper died, and the octopus ate all his acorns, and also he got a race car. Is any of this getting through to you?
Fry, I know those cookies are fresh-alicious, but they produce an awful lot of trash.
Mm.
You're full of crap, Fry. You make a persuasive argument, Fry.
What's so wonderful about Leela being normal? The rest of us aren't normal, and that's what makes us great. Like Dr. Zoidberg. He's a weird monster who smells like he eats garbage and does.
Damn right.
And the professor's a senile, amoral crackpot.
Oh, yeah.
Hermes is a Rastafarian accountant.
Tally me banana.
Amy's a klutz from Mars.
Bloops.
And Fry, you've got that brain thing.
I already did.
Wow, now this is fantastic.
I'm not sure we want to pay for a dimension we're not going to use.
Come on,
man. Don't hold out on me like this.
Behold, the internet!
My
full of ads. The planet's kerploding.
Which way, Fry?
According to this map, the only way out is through that pipe. Don't worry, it gets wider after about a mile.
Idiot.
That thing doesn't have emotions, Fry. Its brain is the size of a walnut.
So are walnuts, and they're delicious.
Fry, is it really you?
I don't know. Is it really you?
What do you mean you don't know? Are you you or not?
Who wants to know?
Oh, Fry, it is you!
First, the civilization of Space Rome collapsed, then Don Martin 3 went kaflooey, and now Tweenus 12.
Looks like this planet is next in line.
That's Earth. The planet we live on?
I'd hate to be those guys. Pine needles. Oh, man, this is great. Hey, as long as you don't make me smell your anus.
I don't get it.
I'm sorry, Fry, but astronomers renamed Uranus in 2620 to end that stupid joke once and for all.
Oh, what's it called now?
Urectum. Here, let me locate it for you.
No.
Interplanetary deliveries. What a headache.
Evans, where's that package from Earth?
I'm not Evans!
He should have used Planet Express.
All right. So the machine produces a few toxic byproducts. You don't have to make a federal case out of it.
I'm afraid I do.
Ooh.
I order you to dispose of that toxic waste properly or bribe me. Either way, it'll cost $500.
500 real dollars? That's an outrage. Professor, I'll take care of that waste for $499.01.
Say, Dollface, how'd you like to make time with a real man?
No, I'm not attracted to bullies, no matter how big and handsome they are.
It's okay, Leela, go ahead. I got a lot of work to do here.
Sir, you don't understand. I'm a professional beach bully. I pretend to steal your girl, you punch me, I go down, she swoons, you slip me $50.
$50? Not even if she was my girlfriend. You take her.
Fry! Although I suppose we could go for a walk on the beach.
No thanks, ma'am. I'm actually gay.
Well, at least here you'll be treated with dignity. Now strip naked and get on the probulator.
Ooh!
Here's my personal book of pickup lines. Say as many of them as you can as fast as you can. Don't stop for any reason.
Amy, if I said you had a beautiful body, would you take your pants off and dance around a little?
What?
Lieutenant Croker!
Oh, I find the most erotic part of a woman is the boobies.
Kiff!
Oh, my.
Screw the quarantine. I'm out of here.
Initiate containment procedure.
Oh! Ah! Ow! Oh!
Go on now.
But I don't like being a delivery boy.
Well, that's tough. Lots of people don't like their jobs, but we do them anyway. You gotta do what you gotta do.
What's happening?
All 6,000 halls have been breached.
Oh, the fools! If only they built it with 6,001 halls. When will they learn?
4,800! 5,000! 5,000 feet!
Dear Lord, that's over 150 atmospheres of pressure. How many atmospheres can the ship withstand? Well, it's a spaceship, so I'd say anywhere between 0 and 1. Just as I suspected, these robots were buried in improperly shielded coffins. Their programming leaked into the castle's wiring through this old abandoned modem, allowing them to project themselves as holograms.
Of course! It was so obvious!
Yes, that sequence of words I said made perfect sense.
2, 3, hey.
Welcome to the world of tomorrow!
Shut up, Terry.
Geez, Hermes, you seem awfully calm about this.
Don't worry, I have a plan.
I'm going to jump!
No!
Oh.
Do a flip!
I heard alcohol makes you stupid. No, I'm... doesn't.
I am Bender. Please insert girder.
But Bender need brain.
for smart-making!
Violent outbursts.
General sluttiness.
Thanks to denial, I'm immortal.
Damn it, I'm supposed to be perfect.
That was the first time I ever believed you were feeling a genuine emotion.
I was. It was shame. I've never felt it before. Makes me want to eat. Do you have a craft services table?
No.
Can stop a monster that big?
Nothing except an even equally big monster. This is a chance to try out my experimental enlarging ray. But we'll need a guinea pig.
What's this? Two meals in 1 week?
Aha! I'm even greater than I thought I was! And now to fulfill my destiny!
The story of lunar exploration started with one man. A man with a dream.
One of these days, Alice, bang, zoom, straight to the moon.
Wow. I never realized the first astronauts were so fat.
That's not an astronaut, it's a TV comedian. And he was just using space travel as a metaphor for beating his wife.
Good morning, lover.
Will you guys shut up? I'm trying to look cool.
Hello? Are there any girls in this room at all?
Yeah, bring on the hot chicks, because I'm a hot stud.
Yeah!
So are we.
I'm a woman, if that's what you mean.
It's a girl. I
don't like to play games, so I'll just say I'm a cyclops, I'm a spaceship captain, I'm the only one of my species, and I'm interested in meeting a man.
A woman? I'm scared.
I can't believe they threw me out like that. I must have been really acting like a jerk.
Yeah, but everybody's a jerk. You, me, this jerk. That's my philosophy. So, where are you gonna stay?
I don't know. Do refrigerators still come in cardboard boxes?
Yeah, but the rents are outrageous.
Gotta go. Fight Club.
What's happening, Hubie?
Oh, I'm afraid the face you fell in love with was actually just a blob of living gunk I bought with my tax refund.
Well, as long as we're being honest, I also spent my tax refund on a crazy treatment.
You can't just waltz into the central bureaucracy. It's a tangled web of red tape and regulations. I've never been, but a friend of mine went completely mad just trying to find the washroom there.
Then we'll need a guide. Someone who's been there before.
Oh, I've been there. Lots of times.
Hey, Brobot, what's your serial number? 3370318? No way! Mine's 2716057!
I don't get it.
We're both expressible as a sum of two cubes! Woo!
Well, it has been a while. Is it okay with you, Fry?
Sure, that'd be great. I'll just sit here and feed the mosquitoes.
Calling all scientists. Be advised there will be a worldwide conference on global warming in Kyoto, Japan.
I've got a degree in homeopathic medicine.
You've got a degree in baloney.
Tonight on Date Night, poplars, eating them. Is it all right to? We have with us the CEO of Fishy Joe's, Mr. Fishy Joseph Gilman, noted anti-eating activist Free Waterfall Jr., and the discoverer of poplars, Captain Taronga Leela.
Taronga?
That's her name, Philip.
Philip?
And it's a dead heat. They're checking the electron microscope, and the winner is number 3 in a quantum finish.
No fair. You change the outcome by measuring it.
Up here in the clouds, our technology makes us invincible, like the mighty X in tic-tac-toe. Look at those pathetic cavemen down there, loading their silly catapult with... What is that, Kiff?
I believe it's a saber-toothed cat, sir.
I'll bid $23 million.
$1 jillion.
Sir, that's not a number.
So, am I gonna drown?
Of course not.
Just stay calm and let the gentle currents relax your every muscle.
Oh, yeah.
Did it just get warmer?
I can't believe you're really real. I like your tail.
Oh, you're sweet. I like those wiggly doodads coming out of your hips.
Oh, thanks. They're called pants.
What should we point it at first?
I don't know. Try it on me. Ow! My sperm!
Wow, neat. Mind if I try that again?
Huh. Didn't hurt that time.
Oh, mama. Hold still, sexy lady.
What's wrong?
That's no lady!
Damn, chica. One more upgrade and I'll be more lady than you can handle. Why you so stupid, stupid?
Hey, bite my shiny metal ass.
You couldn't afford it, honey.
What if one of us is the creature? It could be any of us. Fry, Leela, Amy, Zoidberg.
One of us must be the bad creature. Is it me, maybe?
Planet Express, our crew is replaceable. Your package isn't.
You know, Bender may not have learned anything from me, but I think I actually learned something from him. So long, jerkwads!
So long! While other people were out living their lives, I wasted mine watching TV. Because deep down, I knew it might one day help me save the world. Plus, I would have lost my workman's comp if I had gone outside. Now just read these cue cards. I hate my life.
Get a load of this pathetic 20th century TV.
What's wrong with it?
Well, aside from causing eye cancer, these things had a lousy low-definition picture.
That's true. On a TV like this, I bet you couldn't even make out my obscene tattoo.
That's cute.
Gets out of here, you lousy bum.
Please, I'm scared.
We're all scared. It's the human condition. Why do you think I put on this tough guy facade? Now beat it!
Oh, I try to act cool, but inside I'm freaking out!
I direct your attention to this ancient and mysterious tablet, which has yet to be deciphered.
Do you know what it means?
Yeah, I asked a cop once. It means up yours, kid.
I'm gonna be a science fiction hero, just like Uhura, or Captain Janeway, or Xena.
Fry, this isn't TV. It's real life. Can't you tell the difference?
Sure, I just like TV better. Pew!
Yeah, why is this so important to you?
Because it taught me so much. Like, how you should accept people, whether they be black, white, Klingon, or even female. But most importantly, when I didn't have any friends, it made me feel like maybe I did.
Well, that is touchingly pathetic.
Jeez, this is confusing. And I bet it's gonna get a lot more confusing. Ooh, that cheap beer really goes right through you. For the first time ever, I gotta use the bathroom. But if I leave, I might miss Fry. Unless... 0011, 0011, 0011. And I bet it's gonna get a lot more confusing. Hi, I'm you from 19 seconds in the future. Stay here and wait for Fry while I go to the bathroom. Okay, boss. After I kill Fry, you're next. What? Nothing.
Leela, my sweet, I've come to save you. I have a devious plan.
Oh, great. Captain Moron has a plan. Why don't you tell it to Wingus and Dingus here?
Wingus, Dingus, listen up. We're going to give the aliens the old switcheroo.
You mean...
Correct. I found a giant, hideous ape that looks exactly like Leela.
I'm gonna go build my own theme park with blackjack and hookers. In fact, forget the park.
Just because you saved my life doesn't mean I won't beat you down again.
Man, you are irredeemably evil. Together, we shall rule the galaxy.
Aw, what an adorable little kajigger.
Sure, you can be a comedian instead of a doctor. If you want your parents to roll over in their graves.
You guys were totally out of control.
That's our job. We're peace officers.
Run,
Lunka, lunka, dunkity-doo. We've got a friendly warning for you. Grunka, lunka, dunkity-dasis. The secret of Slurm's on a need-to-know basis.
Asking questions in school is a great way to learn.
If you try that stuff here, you might get your legs broke.
We once found a dead guy face down in the Slurm.
It could easily happen again to you folks.
So keep your head down and keep your mouth shut. Grunka, lunka, lunka, dunkity-dot.
Hey, I don't pay you to sing. You just used up today's bathroom break.
Hard ass.
I heard that.
Remember, it's up to us. Bigfoot is a crucial part of the ecosystem if he exists. So let's all help keep Bigfoot possibly alive for future generations to enjoy unless he doesn't exist. The end!
I am Durr, doctor of the planet Omicron Percy I ate. It appears you may have ingested something toxic. Open your mouth and say, ah! Good God! Here, take some of this herb to ease the pain.
Can you save him?
I could, but he'd only live another 80 years at most. The humane thing is to put him to sleep. Stop! I won't let you do it!
Dad?
Because you have to do it! Be a man for once and flee this wretched creature!
I won't!
When those other companies aren't brave or foolhardy enough to go, trust Planet Express for reliable, on-time delivery.
Here's your package, Mr. Horrible Gelatinous Blob.
Good work, Evans. You've got a future around here.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, I can't take it anymore. They've been at it for hours. Give it a rest, you two.
Sorry.
God, it's Zoidberg. I hate to bother you, but... Okay, I'll shut up!
My poor, sweet robots can't exterminate humanity without being told to.
I'm sorry.
Oh, it's not your fault.
I give up. It's time to face the fact that I'll never do anything remotely interesting or unexpected again.
I don't know how this was supposed to work.
Can you translate it?
Of course, but only into Beta Crypt 3, a language so complex there's even less chance of understanding it.
I didn't ask for a completely reasonable excuse. I asked you to get busy.
Very well.
Isn't that the same machine that makes noses?
It can do other things. Why shouldn't it?
Dateline Paramecium Homeworld. Newly crowned Miss Universe, Gladys Lennox entertains troops fighting to wipe out the human race. Go get them, boys!
Bureaucrat Conrad, if you complete your death transaction without filing a suicide and or falling accident permit, you will be posthumously demoted.
Life, death, either way, I'm demoted to a tiny cubicle.
Release the giant sloth!
Hey, I'm Elsa. Welcome to the show. You know, you don't have to drive all the way to Neptune for great Neptunian food. Today, we're gonna kick it up a notch as I show you how to fricassee a mouth-watering Neptunian slug. Woo-wee! Now, while you're greasing the pan and preheating your oven to 3,500 degrees, you're gonna separate the yolk from your genetically enhanced eggplant and then give the whole thing a good blast from your spice weasel. Bam! Your most important ingredient is this baby right here, the Neptunian slug. You can get it in a can, but to really do things right, you gotta strangle yourself a fresh one. Now, this is why you always want to use cast iron cookware.
Into the waiting arms of my new assistant. Just stand here, like so. Good.
I'll fall backwards, and you catch me. I trust you!
My fellow fish monsters, far be it from me to question your stupid civilization or its dumb customs. But is squeezing each other's brains out with a giant nutcracker really gonna solve anything? Dr. Zoidberg is my friend, and though a woman has come between us, I say we'll always remain friends. And you know why? One reason. You bastard! I'll kill you! You bastard!
Hand it over.
What? Hurry up, I want to see the moon.
Relax, it's open till 9.
That's one small step for Fry.
And one giant line for admission.
Giff, follow me up to the observation deck. I've got some musing to do.
Oh, jeez.
This is gonna be great.
Hey, oh, buddy.
Bingo.
Oh, mama.
Oh, yeah. Someone's been a bad computer. Get a load of that.
Not right to make my dead pet an exhibit. That's like digging up Lassie and putting her on display in the Louvre.
Lassie is on display in the Louvre.
I know. I was deliberately describing a similar situation.
Thing isn't worth the gold it's made of. Anyway, the thing longer seems to be a rousing success. Good work.
Congratulations, Jack. Right on, Professor.
So that's what things would be like if I'd invented the thing longer. Oh, a man can dream, though. A man can dream.
Hi, I'm Crater Face. Welcome to Luna Park. I'll have to confiscate your alcohol, sir.
Better mascots than you have tried.
At least I still have my self-respect.
Ha,